All right, let's pray. Everlasting Father, we thank you for this time in your word. Let your counsel prevail, inspire, stir. Thank you, Father, for you never leave us stranded. Thank you for your goodness towards us. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to start out by reading to you a short excerpt from my message for this Sunday, what I'm going to be sharing from this Sunday. And then I will extract a sliver from it and build on it as the Lord's core word for today. Charles, good to have you. Thank you for your testimony of yesterday. Really blessed me. All right. I'm going to read a part of my message for Sunday, take a part of it, and expound on it as our concept for today. It's not exactly the thought line for Sunday's message, but it will give us an introduction into this. Let's start. It is important to note that God is intentional about every action he takes. Listen carefully. It is important to note that God is intentional about every action he takes. Our finite minds might fail to see or understand his purpose due to its limited processing power, but nonetheless, every action of God factors a plethora of scenarios, possibilities, past, current, future events, natural laws, eternal laws, man's free will, and the butterfly effect, just to name a few. We must never forget that when we put side by side our finite minds with its finite processing power, it pales in comparison and in comprehension to the infinite mind of God. I think I should say that again. We must never forget that when we put side by side our finite minds with its finite processing power, it pales in comparison and comprehension to the infinite mind that we call God Almighty. We need to appreciate that even in our wildest, this is important, we need to appreciate that even in our wildest imagination, which is God's gift to man to give him the ability to taste of the powers of infinity, the reaches of our imagination is still limited by the quality of information we have to work with. Let me say it again. Let me try and say it slowly. We need to appreciate that even in our wildest imagination, which is God's gift to man to taste the powers of infinity, the reaches of our imagination is still limited by the quality of information we have to work with. Which means it is near impossible to think about something without a frame of reference. I'll say it again. This means it is near impossible for you and I to think about something without a frame of reference. Without infinite knowledge, even an infinite imagination will experience a finite output. Let me say it again. Without infinite knowledge, even an infinite imagination will experience a finite output. God is the infinite mind. Hear me? God is the infinite mind. The concept of thought is a strange peculiarity when it comes to the workings of the infinite mind. Particularly, and more specifically, when it comes to the workings of God. Let me say it again. The concept of thought is a strange peculiarity when it comes to the workings of the infinite mind, when it comes to the workings of God. The complexity of this is further exacerbated by the combination. Listen, this whole concept of thought with God is further complicated when we consider the fact that God is a being that is all-knowing, but also exists in a timeless arena. Because God exists in a timeless arena, the concept of thought for God is dramatically different from its concept as it relates to us. What do I mean? It means then, because God does not exist in time, when God cannot have a thought, look, let me start with this. A thought from God to us is considered as a new thought, but God cannot have a new thought. A new thought from God will mean that God has just thought of a thing that he did not know before. God cannot think a thought he has not already thought. Because to think a new thought, you need to be within the restrictions of time. So a new thought is new to us from our perspective, but a new thought, a thought has already been contemplated before time. Give you an example in scripture. This is why the Bible then says that the Lamb of God was slain before the foundation of the world. He manifested in our time, but before our time, the whole process of the coming of Jesus, his life and death and resurrection, had already occurred, because God cannot think a thought he has not already thought of. Now watch this. Why is this important? Now, because when you begin to appreciate, you need to hear the message on Sunday. When you begin to appreciate where the thought, in quote, of God is coming from, when you appreciate that the thought of God is coming from an infinite perspective, is coming from the infinite mind, you will then be able to acknowledge that there is a variety of creativity that is in God and that is left in God, and that is our responsibility to find out. This is why the Bible then says that it is the honor of kings to search it out. It is the blessing of God to conceal a matter. God, the thoughts, the creativity, the insight is concealed, and it is our honor to find it out, to search it out. The thoughts of God are deep thoughts. This is the message for this morning. God wants us to appreciate that in Him still resides an overwhelming variety of thoughts, concepts, ideas, and creativities to answer, a variety of ways actually to deal with the singular problem that you are facing. God is replete with a number of strategies, techniques, and tactics to deal with whatever situation you are facing. What needs to happen is you and I need to be willing to settle down and think with Him. Listen, when a finite mind begins to engage with an infinite mind that has to factor in several conditions, you need to appreciate that to walk with God requires patience, that to walk with God requires time. This is why Jesus spent 30 years thinking with God, and by the time he was done, he was so inundated with the capacities of the infinite mind that he was able to even raise himself from the dead. Jesus said, "No man takes my life, I lay it down and I will take it up again." He was so consumed, and that's what happens when you spend time with the infinite mind. The capacities of the infinite mind begins to rub off on yours. There is no excuse for a believer to be stranded. There is no excuse for a believer to think he's without option. Without option on how to get what he wants. Without option on how to get where he needs to go. Without, option on how to move natural laws or invade the natural laws and circumvent them with spiritual laws to accomplish that which God will have him accomplish. Saints, appreciate the fact that we have been given the capacity to think so that we can think with God. You need to make time daily to clear your schedule to sit down to think. One of the definitions of prayer is contemplations with God. Not just contemplations of God, which is a kind of prayer. It is also contemplations with God. To sit down, to think through a matter with the infinite mind sitting with you. Somebody needs to hear what I'm saying. Have you noticed that we are dealing with an infinite mind that has infinite creativity, that till today, people are still being born into the world and no two people have the same fingerprint? As ordinary and blasé as that might sound, please understand that it intimates us with the creativity of God. Did you notice that God created man once, has not stepped in a second time to recreate, to redo what he has created, and yet the process he did from the beginning is still churning out new creatures, new human beings with different thumbprints. One move of God, and for centuries is still producing new elements. Just one move. That is an example of the capacity of the infinite mind. And that infinite mind says that to the believer, he now dwells in you. He says, I will be with you and I will be in you. When you walk with God, when you interface with the infinite mind, it breaks the limitations of your finite mind, brings you into the creation of things that hitherto did not exist. We are dealing with, this is the reason why Jesus was given a parable, and he spoke about a man who saw treasure in a field, and then he sells everything he had to buy the field. You need to hear Sunday's message. He sells everything he has to buy the field. Do you know why the man did that? Because the man encountered the infinite mind. When you encounter God in his infinitum, what you immediately realize is that you have suddenly been exposed to an infinite room of infinite possibilities. An infinite room filled with infinite possibilities. That's what occurs. This is the reason why when Job had complained and whined and battled and struggled with the goodness of God, the justice of God, the interest of God, at some point when God began to expose his infinitum to Job, this was Job's response. Job said, I will place my hand on my mouth, I will speak no more. Job said, I realize now that as I look at God, my goodness, when you are in the presence of greatness, you stop talking and you start listening. Understand? This is why the Bible tells us in Proverbs 13. I want to read that to you. Proverbs 13, verse 20 says, he that walks with the wise shall be wise, but a companion of fools shall be destroyed. He that walks with the wise shall be wise, a companion of fools shall be destroyed. Your mind is God's platform. God wants to use your mind as his whiteboard. You know the whiteboard that you have in school that is used to teach you? God needs our minds to become his whiteboard so that he can, and the whiteboard needs to be clean, because one of the things I saw in the spirit was the whiteboards of our mind filled with a lot of information, a lot of calculations. It was already filled with a lot of stuff. And as God began to write on the whiteboard, he was having to cram a lot of information into a corner. And because it was in a corner, God's desire to speak to us was still there. Even though the whiteboard of your mind is full, God is still speaking. The challenge, though, is there is a limit to how much space is available. There is a limit to how much he can cram in there. And if he crams more in there, it becomes ineligible for you to see. The necessity then is for us to clean the whiteboards of our minds. This is why the Bible speaks in Romans 12 that we need to be renewed. We need to be transformed by the renewing of our mind. This again deals with what I mentioned. Was it on Monday or Tuesday? About the necessity for us to deal with our prejudices and our preferences / biases, so that the whiteboards of your mind is open for the infinite mind to give you new information. You are not stranded. You just need to think with the infinite mind. You are not without options. You are not, your back is not against the wall. You are just in need of time with the infinite mind. The thing about the infinite mind is this. Sometimes when you are spending time with God and you are spending time to think through a matter in the presence of the Holy Spirit, it might look as though you are not doing much of anything. It might look as though you are wasting time while other people are busy in one activity or the other. But the difference is this. One concept from God, one idea from God, one introduction production from the infinite mind, remember the consequence of an idea from a superior thought. The consequence of an idea from an infinite mind, hear me, is that when you bring that thought from an infinite mind or the infinite mind into a finite space, it will fill the space. And if you got the thought unadulterated, it will blow up the space. Because you have taken something that comes from a limitless arena and you have attempted to cramp it into a limited space, it will fill the space. When you take a concept from the infinite mind and you introduce it, you create the discipline to workshop that thought into a finite atmosphere. Do you know the consequence? It will look like when you are in a small room and you open a box of perfume that has a very powerful fragrance. The whole room will be filled with it. Whether people want to smell it or not, whether people want like the fragrance or not, as long as they are in that room, they will be overwhelmed and they will perceive the aroma that you have released. This is why it is essential that we daily create time to workshop our thoughts with the infinite mind. It is not so that we will sound intelligent, because what will sounding intelligent do? It is so that we can birth divine purposes, bring to pass divine outcomes that will change your life. And it needs to be more than that, that will change the lives of the people that Jesus ultimately died for, which is not just you or I. He died for the world. The cry from the heavens this morning is that we will stay with him. Oh my goodness. The Bible speaks, Jesus said, but that man who wants to pray should go into the room, lock the door. Then it says that the God that sees in secret will minister to him. The Bible then speaking about this God that dwells in secret, and he dwells in secret because the information is not hidden from you. The information is hidden for you. But if it's placed in the open, then everyone will get it. But it is hidden for you. And so you need to go and meet him in that secret place. You need to go and meet him in secret. Have you ever been in that situation where somebody wants to share a secret with you and the person calls you and says, come follow me? And then the person looks around and then you enter a room, the person closes the door, and then the person begins to share a secret information. It's the same thing here. Close the door. The whole concept is so that you will appreciate that what you are about to encounter, what you are about to extract, is going to blow your mind. God wants to blow your mind. He needs you to begin conversations with the infinite mind. I'm writing a book and it has to deal with that. And it will take me probably another 5 years to finish. Because when you begin to interact with a mind that has no limits, a mind that has no restriction, a mind that is not bound by time, matter, or space, you need to be patient. Because the concepts there have to work with the frame, with what frames of reference that you have in your finite mind. And that might take us time to be able to distill. But hence, we have been given the Holy Spirit, who is able to break it down into concepts that you can appreciate. I say again, God wants to blow your mind. And so he requires, and you require, that you create time to just think. You need to take the business to a new level is to think with the infinite mind. You need to move the ministry further to think with the infinite mind. You need to heal yourself or heal somebody else to think with the infinite mind. Let me tell you something that happened yesterday. So one of my people had called me, my Brigalia, having a pain in her back. A pain in her back, she has not been sleeping. When I sat with the infinite mind to pray, because I know what the scripture says, I don't have the opportunity to lay hands on her. But the scripture speaks about how we can send forth the word and heal. As I sat with the infinite mind to proceed to pray, the infinite mind, my mind was open to see what the infinite mind wanted done. And I saw the infinite mind, God Almighty, reach out to her, pull out her spine, complete with the bone structure of her lower waistline, and I saw the inflammation. I saw it. It was a red mass at the bottom of her spine. And he pulled it and he dipped it in a liquid that looks like water. I will call it water for now. As he dipped it there, he kept it long enough. When he pulled it out, I assume the water had quenched the inflammation. And then he put it back in her spine. And this was what he said to me, that this, what you have just seen, what your finite mind has just witnessed, is an intangible move of God, something that your normal eyes could not have seen. And if you will take that picture and declare it, that is what you would have experienced. And so I took that picture, declared it. By the time I called her in the evening, she says to me that the whole day, she went to bed, woke up at 6 a.m. and the whole day she had now been without pain, a pain that had existed for an extended period of time. You see, when you begin to allow your mind, you go into God's word, read God's word so that it purifies your thought process, but you create time. It takes time to know God. It takes time to know anything. Actually, it takes time to know anything. And there is enough time for you to know God enough for you to enter into a dimension of manifestation that will be synonymous with a clear reflection of the Almighty. I say to you today, think with the infinite mind. Create time to, after you've read his word, create time to say to the one that has infinitum in his capacities and in his contemplations, to say to him, can we think? Remember what God says. He says, come, let us reason together. Oh, the infinite mind is putting out an invitation to you. Come, let us reason together. David got a glimpse of this and said in Psalm 42, deep calls to deep. Oh, I have some interesting things to say about that verse when on Sunday. It says, deep calls unto deep. Ooh, he's saying there is a depth. Ooh, let me give you this one. David was saying there is a depth in me that cries out to the depth that's you. Let me say it again. He says, David was saying, and I paraphrase, there is a depth in me that is crying out to the depth that is you. My goodness, there is a call. Deep calls to deep. Your thoughts are God's weapon given to you and I. Our thoughts, God's weapon given to you and I to free us from all forms of bondage, to free us from all forms of limitation. Guard your thoughts. Open your thoughts. Begin conversations, boardroom meetings. But you are in your marketplace assignments, when there is a boardroom meeting that is important, you don't miss it if you're a member of the board, particularly in these times of crisis. You don't miss it. Saints, it's time for you to understand that you belong to the boardroom of the highest decision-making body in the universe. You belong to the boardroom of the highest decision. And because you belong to that boardroom, hear me, and because you belong to that boardroom, it is time for you to start attending board meetings. Start attending board meetings. The mind that is in that boardroom is, will leave you flabbergasted. You need to attend those board meetings daily so that your world can be without drama. There's so much more to say. I will stop there. I want to pray for you. Let's pray. Everlasting Father, I thank you first and foremost for the testimonies that have been birthed from yesterday's encounters with you. Those that have shared their testimonies and many more that are going to share today, going to share into this weekend, going to share into next week because of the things that you have done. I'm grateful for it. Now, oh God, we accept the call to attend boardroom sessions with the quality of mind that is in that boardroom, your mind. We accept the call to attend the sessions. You open our consciousness. You cause there to be a clarity for us. We make the effort to create the time, to read your word and create the time that our minds can be flooded with your ideas. We will no longer wonder how, because in the idea, in the interaction, is everything we need. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Let me add this. Time with the infinite mind is so profound, so mystical, that even if you walk away without an immediate idea to implement, you never walk away the same way you were when you came. Did you hear me? It never happens. Brace yourself. Brace yourself. If you will do as I'm instructing, go watch all the messages I taught since Monday. Follow through with the thought process. If you will do as instructed, you will see as prescribed. If you will do as instructed, you will see as prophesied. Okay? I hope you've been blessed. One more time. It's Tango and Tim tomorrow. Are you ready? We are ready. We had a final conversation with all the guests yesterday. And then today, we're doing a complete tech rehearsal to make sure we're able to give you a wonderful presentation that will help your relationship, that will bless your marriage, that will bless you as a single person if you will choose to listen. I want to encourage you, come on board. It's going to be on Zoom. Click the link, come into our home, our space, and join us. If you are in that Zoom video call, if there is something that we explain you don't understand, you can ask for clarification. If also there is a question that you would like us to answer, we'll be creating space for you to do that. You will, if you are watching this on any other platform, if we choose to stream on any other platform, we will not be taking questions from that platform. We will only be taking questions from those that are on the Zoom link. So hopefully you will be there with us. Masterclass, come on board. It will bless you. It will change your life. If some of the things I've shared here, we are going to be bringing them into a practical space at the masterclass so that you manifest a lot quicker all that you are supposed to be. Come into the class with me. If you're interested, send us an email. It will do you a world of good. God bless you. I hope to catch you tomorrow at Tango and Tim. Click the link. It will bless you. Bye for now. I'm going to attend my boardroom meeting. Catch you on Friday.